Hello, welcome to netvn. I would like to show you how to clone from one hard drive to multiple hard drives. Here I have a solid state drive as the source hard drive. The two traditional hard drives are the target hard drives. Also, you need a USB drive. Its purpose will be covered in the next part of the video. You connect the source hard drive to the computer. Then you plug the USB stick to the computer. You power on the computer and start Windows. These are the drives on the computer, a Windows solid state drive and a USB drive. The software used to clone a hard drive is called clonezilla. I will show you how to use clonezilla to clone from one hard drive to multiple hard drives. USB drive used to create bootable clonezilla USB. Here is the clonezilla ISO file after it is downloaded. After you download the stable version of clonezilla, you use a bootable USB drive creation software. My favorite software is called Rufus. A compact software and no installation required. You open Rufus software and select the USB drive. I recommend that you use a USB drive of sufficient capacity to save the Windows system image. You browse to the file with the ISO extension downloaded in the previous step. Next, you format the USB drive as NTFS. After the above settings, you can start creating a bootable clonezilla USB. Rufus will erase the data on your USB drive and overwrite new files on it. And here is the USB drive when finished. Next, you restart your computer and boot from clonezilla USB. In the BIOS, you set the computer to boot from the newly created USB drive. You save the changes, start the computer from clonezilla USB. Clonezilla live to RAM. Clonezilla copies files to RAM and boots from there. So clonezilla is booted from RAM and you can use the USB drive as a storage device. Start clonezilla. Before cloning to traditional hard drives, you create a new image of the solid state drive. You choose to work with hard drives and images for local devices such as local hard drives and USB drives. Here is a list of my local devices including a 240GB solid-state drive and a 64GB USB hard drive. Next, you choose where to store the image of the solid-state drive that will be created. You scroll down and select the USB drive. This is the list of folders on the USB drive. I choose to save the image in the top directory of the USB drive. Beginner mode. You leave the default to save the entire drive as an image. This is the automatically generated image folder name. You can change it if you want. I leave it as default. Then you choose the source hard drive. If your computer has multiple hard drives, make sure to select the correct source drive. Skip checking or repairing source file system. Skip checking the saved image. I don't want to encrypt the image file, so I leave it as default. Lots of settings, but almost done. Press enter to continue. Press Y to continue. At this point, your hard drive begins to be saved as a backup image. Clonezilla will back up the partitions on your source hard drive one after another. It is up to your data to decide the hard drive image creation time. The image of the hard drive has been created. Now you restart the computer. I start Windows to check the results. You access the BIOS and let the computer boot from the hard drive. On Windows, you go to the USB drive and you will see there is a new folder named Asset in the step of creating the image file. This is the folder where the images of my solid-state drive are stored. In the next part, I will use this image to clone it to two traditional hard drives. In this example, I only cloned it to two hard drives, but you can clone to multiple hard drives at the same time if you want. You turn off the computer and remove the source hard drive. Here I remove the solid-state drive. Then connect the two traditional hard drives to the computer. I will restore the image created in the previous step onto these two traditional hard drives. Make sure the Clonezilla USB is still plugged into the computer. The image of the source hard drive is being saved on this USB drive. You go to the BIOS and change the boot order. You set up your computer to boot from Clonezilla USB. Clonezilla live to RAM. You start Clonezilla from RAM. Same as last time, you set the keyboard and language to use while cloning the hard drive. You choose to work with drives and images. You choose to work with local devices such as local hard drives and USB drives. Here is a list of hard drives and USB drives. I have two 1 TB traditional hard drives and one 64 GB USB drive. You choose where to store the images to clone. Here I choose a USB drive. If the hard drives have been divided into partitions, make sure to select the correct USB drive that stores the image created in the previous step. These are folders on the USB drive, including a folder that stores images of the hard drive. Here you choose expert mode. You choose expert mode to clone between different sized hard drives. Next, you choose to restore an image to multiple hard drives at the same time. This is the folder where the images are stored. If you backup multiple times, there is more than one option for you. You choose the target hard drives. I choose both traditional hard drives. Thus, I will restore the image file to both destination hard drives. Next, you enable ICDS. ICDS will help you clone between different sized hard drives. Because the source and destination hard drives have different sizes, you create corresponding partitions on the target hard drives. Next, I skip the image check because it will be faster. It will be more prudent to check the image before restoring. Press Y to continue. Press Y to continue. After the above settings, the image will be restored to the destination hard drives. In this case, the image of the solid-state drive is restored to two traditional hard drives. So I have finished introducing how to clone one hard drive to multiple hard drives with Clonezilla software. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and help me 600,000 subscribers. Next, I will check the results. I turn off the computer and remove the USB drive. Then I removed one of the two traditional drives. I start the computer with one of the two traditional hard drives. As you can see, Windows boots successfully, so I have successfully cloned from the source hard drive to the destination hard drive. Good luck!